Find the integral of the function in exercises 1 to 22. First question is sine square 2x plus 5. So let integral be sine square 2x plus 5 dx. Now before this I told you we cannot use power rule for the sine or cosine function, means for trigonometry, because if a composite rule for the integral is what we have to divide by the composite function. Suppose 2x plus 2 whole square is there, so we can use 2x plus integration will be 2x plus 2 whole cube and divide by the coefficient of this, that is 2, and into power also. Okay, so this we can do. If we can divide, if we get the constant number in denominator. Suppose in case of sine square x, the integral of sine square x, if we take like this, sine is sine cube x by 3, and derivative of sine is cos x. So this is function, so we should not divide by any function, because the reason is, see, I told you integration and derivative are opposite to each other. So if we take integral of this will be this, if we take derivative of this we will get the integral question. Okay, now for this part, if you take derivative of this, we won't get integral of sine square. You can verify your answer. So here what we will do, we will use identity. So for such cases, sine square, sine cube, sine power 4, sine power 5, you can use identity here. So we know the identity, 1 minus cos 2x is 2 sine square x, and 1 plus cos 2x is 2 cos square x. So here sine square we want, this we want. So we can write sine square x as 1 minus cos 2x by 2. Now the thing is here x, so here twice of x. So now for our question, it is sine square 2x plus 5. So we can write 1 minus cos twice of the angle divide by 2. So this expression will substitute in the question. So we'll get here 1 minus cos of 2 times 2x plus 5 divide by 2 dx. 1 by 2 we can take outside, and then 1 minus cos 4x plus 10 we can write, isn't it? Now separate the integral. So 1 dx minus cos of 4x plus 10 dx. Now we know integral 1 is what? X. And integral cos means sine of the angle, and since this angle is composite, divide by the derivative of this, which will be 4 plus c. So we can write final answer as x by 2 sine 4x plus 10 divide by 4 plus c. For question number 2, sine 3x cos 4x. So let the integral be I sine 3x cos 4x. Now here multiplication of two trigonometry is there, and we know product rule is not there for integral. Okay, integration by part is there. That is the different thing. Here we should use identity. Okay, so we know defactorization formula. Means if we have two terms, same 2 cos A cos B, we can write in terms of addition of two trigonometry, that is cos of A plus B plus cos of A minus B, isn't it? If we have two function sine A sine B, then we can write cos of A minus B minus cos of A plus B. Okay, then if we have two sine A cos B, so we can write sine of A plus B plus sine of A minus B. And if we have 2 cos A sine B, then we can write sine of A plus B minus sine of A minus B. Okay. So here if you observe sine A cos B, means third formula we can apply here, in which A will be 3x and B will be 4x. But the thing is 2 is not there. So first arrangement will be, we should divide and multiply with 2. Okay. Now since we can write this formula inside the bracket as a justification of our step, since 2 sin a cos b is sin a plus b plus sin a minus b. So we can write this expression inside the integral as sin of 3x plus x plus sin of 3x minus x. Okay, now we can add and subtract here. So sin 4x plus sin 2x. Separate the integral. So half integral sin 4x dx plus half integral sin 2x dx. So last step will be, final will be, integral of sin 4x is minus cos 4x, isn't it? So we will get minus cos 4x divide by 4, and already 2 is there, so divide by 8 will come. Here also cos 2x divide by 2, and 2 is already there, so 4 will come plus c. For question number 3, first let the integral be I. Now we did in previous question, we saw 4 formulae, isn't it? So if we have cos A, cos B. So here 3 terms are there. So first what we will do, we'll make a pair of 2 cos term. Then we can apply the formula here. So for that, we should multiply and divide with 2. Okay. So for this expression, we can apply the formula, which will be, see, both cos means cos of A plus cos of B. And last, cos 6x term will be same. Now, 2x plus 4x means cos 6x. And here, 2x minus 4x means minus 2x. But we know cos of minus theta is positive cos theta. So we can write as cos of 2x. Now we can multiply the bracket. Cos square 6x will come, and cos 2x cos 6x. Okay. Now here also, for this we have identity here. Okay. For this we have an identity. 1 plus cos square x, we know 1 plus cos square x is 2 cos square. 1 plus cos 2x, we know 2 cos square x. Okay. Now here cos square 6x is there. Cos square 6x. So double of this will come. That means 1 plus cos 12x will be 2 cos square 6x. So cos square 6x we can write 1 plus cos 12x by 2. And for this expression, again we can apply the defactorization formula. So here I am writing 1 plus cos 12x by 2. And here 2 cos 2x cos 6x by 2. Multiply and divide by the 2. Okay. Now see here, 1 by 2. 1 plus cos 12x, and here 1 by 2 will come, and this is a and this is b. So same formula we can apply, cos a plus b, that is cos 8 plus cos a minus b means 2x minus 6x, which is 4x. Okay, so we can separate the integral now. Half. Now here is also 2 is there. So this 1 by 2, 1 by 2 from both the expression we can take outside. So this 2 will become 4. Okay. And integral 1 dx, integral cos 12x dx, integral cos 8x dx plus integral cos 4x dx. These 4 integral will be left. So finally we can write 1 by 4, integral 1 dx means x, cos 12x means sin 12x by 12, cos 8x means sin 8x by 8 and cos 4x means sin 4x by 4. Question number 4. Let the integral be I. Now here sin cube is there. Okay. So we have one formula. Sin 3x we know. 3 sin x minus 4 sin cube x. That means cube we can write as 4 sin cube we can write as 3 sin x minus sin 3x. Okay. So sin cube x will be what? 3 by 4 sin x minus sin 3x by 4. So this we can apply here. So 3 by 4 sin x minus sin 3x by 4 dx. Okay. Now separate the integral. So 3 by 4 sin x dx minus sin 3x by 4 dx. 3 by 4 sin x dx we can write, and 1 by 4 sin 3x dx. Now integral of sin x is what? Minus cos. So we can write minus 3 cos x by 4. And here integral of sin 3x is what? Minus cos 3x. So minus is already there. So plus cos 3x by 4 3s are 12 will come. Plus c. Question number 5. Let the integral be I. So sin cube x cos cube x dx. See here we can write sin x cos x whole cube. Isn't it? Now we have an identity 2 sin x cos x is equal to sin 2x. So here we got this sin x cos x term, but 2 is not there. Okay, to write this identity. So we should, since cube is there, so we should divide and multiply with 2 cube. That is 1 by 8. And 8, if we multiply with 8, that will go inside the bracket. We can write 2 sin x cos x cube. Now for this, we can apply the formula, that is sin 2x whole cube. Okay. Now we got the sin cube. So sin, for the sin cube x, in last question we got one formula here, 3 by 4 sin x minus sin 3x by 4, isn't it? Now here we have sin cube 2x. So this will be 2x, this will be 2x, and this will be 6x. Okay. So we can write formula 3 by 4 sin 2x minus sin 6x by 4 dx. Now we can separate the integral. So 1 by 8, 3 by 4 will come out sin 2x, okay, dx, minus 1 by 8, and 1 by 4 will come out sin 6x dx. So this we can write 3 by 32 integral of sin x is minus cos 2x by 2, and this we can write minus, but integral of sin will be minus, so this will become plus 1 by 32 cos 6x by 6 plus c. So final answer we can write here minus 3 cos 2x divided by 64, and here we can write 192 plus c. Question number 6. Let the integral be I. Now here three sine functions are in multiplication. So we have one formula here. For 2 sine a sine b, we can write cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. Okay. This formula we can use for first 2 trigonometry. Okay, so for that we need 2 here, so we should multiply with 2 and divide by 2. So for this we can apply the formula. That is cos of a minus b. A is x and b is 2x. So x minus 2x. Okay, so minus x only. But since cos is there, so we can write x, because cos of minus x will be what? Positive cos x. Now minus cos of a plus b means 3x. X plus 2x means 3x into sine 3x dx. Now 1 by 2. We can multiply this sine 3x with the bracket. We'll get cos x sine 3x minus cos 3x sine 3x. Okay. Now, see this function again. We can use the identity. 2 cos a sine b is what? Sine a plus b minus sine a minus b. Okay. This we can use for the first integral, but for the second one we can divide and multiply with 2, and we can use the identity 2 sine theta cos theta is equal to sine 2 theta, because here we have both angles same. So that we can, this we can use here. Okay, so for the first integral this identity, and for the second integral, first let's separate the integral here. Okay, so here we need to multiply and divide by 2. So in this step only we can do, and here also. So 1 by 4, 1 by 4. Now 1 by 4. For this we can apply the sine a plus b. So a is x and b is 3x. So sine 4x will come minus sine of a minus b. See, x minus 3x means minus 2x. And we know sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. So plus sine 2x will come. Minus 1 by 4. This formula will give c theta, that means sine 2 theta, double of the angle. So here 3x means double will be sine 6x. So we can write sine 6x dx. So now 1 by 4 we can take out, and we can separate the integral sine 4x dx plus sine 2x dx minus sine 6x dx. Next step we can write 1 by 4. We got as sine integral sine 4x dx plus integral sine 2x dx minus integral sine 6x dx. This we got in previous step. So now we know integral of sine is minus cos 4x divide by 4. So better don't write in bracket. Here we can write this as minus, inside we can write, and 1 by 4 is the common constant. Okay, so minus cos 4x by 4, here minus cos 2x by 2, and here plus sine x by 6 plus c we can write. Question number 7, let the integral be I. So sine 4x sine 8x dx. Now we know our one identity, 2 sine a sine b is cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. So here our a is 4x and b is 8x. So this identity we can use here. But for that, we need 2 here. So first, we should multiply and divide by 2. Now, we can apply the identity cos of 4x minus 8x minus cos of 4x plus 8x. Okay. So, integral. Here, we'll get 4x minus 8 means cos of minus 4, isn't it? But cos of minus 4 will be equal to cos of plus 4, because we know cos of minus theta is cos theta. So cos 4x minus cos 12x. Now we can separate the integration here. So half इंटीग्रल कॉस 4x dx माइनस इंटीग्रल कॉस 12x dx, एंड वी नो कॉस 4x इंटीग्रल इज व्हाट, साइन 4x बाय 4 माइनस कॉस 12 मीन्स साइन 12x बाय 12 प्लस सी। क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, लेट द इंटीग्रल बी आई, सो 1 माइनस कॉस एक्स 1 प्लस कॉस एक्स डी एक्स। ओके, नाउ वी नो 1 माइनस कॉस 2 एक्स इज 2 साइन स्क्वायर एक्स, एंड 1 माइनस कॉस 1 प्लस कॉस 2 एक्स इज 2 कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स। नाउ हियर वी हैव एक्स एक्स हियर, इफ यू ऑब्जर्व 2 एक्स सो हाफ ऑफ द एंगल, सो इफ वी हैव कॉस एक्स so half of x means sine square x by 2, so this we can write in numerator, and cos x we have cos square x by 2, this we can write in denominator, so integral will become 2 sine square x by 2 divided by 2 cos square x by 2 dx. 2 cancel, sine square by cos square we can write 10 square x by 2. Now we don't have any direct formula for tan square, but for sec square we have. Sec square is what, tan x plus c. So, but we can make tan square, isn't it? We can use the identity sec square x minus 1 equal to tan square x. So here we will write sec square x by 2 minus 1 dx. Now we can separate the integral sec square x by 2 minus dx will come, integral 1 dx. Now this will give tan x by 2 and divide by the derivative of x by 2, which is half minus x plus c. So finally we can write answer as 2 tan of x by 2 minus x plus c. Let the integral be I, so cos x 1 plus cos x dx. Here we will do one arrangement. We will add 1 and subtract 1 in numerator. Okay. Now we can separate the denominator. 1 plus cos x by 1 plus cos x minus 1 by 1 plus cos x. So this we can cancel here. That means we'll be left with 1 minus 1 by. In previous question, we used cos 2 cos square x by 2 for this particular expression. So here also we can use that one, 2 cos square x by 2. Now integral 1 minus 1 by cos square, we can write sec square x by 2 divided by 2. Okay. Now separate the integral here. So 1 dx will come, and 1 by 2 we can take out, sec square x by 2 dx. For one integral, integral 1 answer will be x. For this will be minus 1 by 2, and for this answer will be 10 x by 2 divided by coefficient of x by 2, that is half. So this 2 will go here. So final answer we can get x minus 10 x by 2 plus. Question number 10. See, as I told you, whenever power 2 or 4 or 5 will come for the sine or cos, we can use the identity. Okay. So here also we know 1 minus cos 2x is 2 sine square x. That means sine square x we can write as 1 minus cos 2x by 2. So we can write sine 4, power 4 we can write square and square. Okay, then for this particular expression we will use this formula. So 1 minus cos 2x by 2 whole square will come dx. Now 1 by 4 we can take outside, and inside the bracket, this bracket we can use, we can open using identity a minus b whole square. So a square minus 2ab plus b square. Okay. Now for this integral, tension, no tension for this also, but for this square is there. That means again we need to simplify this. So again one another identity we'll use here, 1 plus cos 2x is 2 cos square x. So we need here 2x, and this 2x we need here. That means here angle will be 4x. So cos square 2x we can write 1 plus cos 4x by 2. So 1 minus 2 cos 2x, and cos square 2x we can write 1 plus cos 4x by 2. Now we can separate the integral. 1 dx minus 2 outside cos 2x dx. Here half outside half dx and half into cos 4x dx. Okay, so final answer we can get here. See this half and 1 inside the integral also we can add, and after that we can separate. But as I did this step, so let me complete this one. 1 by 4 integral 1 dx means x will come minus 2. Integral cos 2x we know, sine 2x by 2 plus this will give half x, that is x by 2, and this will give half into sine 4x by 4 plus c will come. Okay, now this x by 2 we can add, which will give 3x by 2. Here 2 will go, so we can write sine 2x, and here sine 4x by 4 we can write. Is already there. 2 is there, no? 4 to the 8 we can write. Question number 11 is of the same type as question number 10. So let the integral be I cos power 4 2x. We can write as cos square 2x whole square. Then for this we can use the identity, that is 1 plus cos 4x by 2 whole square. Then 1 by 4 outside, and inside the bracket we can use identity 1 plus 2 cos 4x plus cos square 4x. Then for this also we can use identity, that is 1 plus cos 8x by 2. Okay. Now, as I told you, this 1 by 2 and 1 here only we can add. So 3 by 2 it will give 2 cos 4x plus cos 8x by 2. Now we can separate the integral. So 1 by 4, 3 by 2 dx, 2 times cos 4x dx plus half cos 8x dx. So 1 by 4. This will give 3 by 2x. Here integral of cos is sine 4x. So 2 sine 4x by 4. And here sine 8x by 8. So 1 by 4, 3x by 2. This 2 we can cancel. So sine 4x by 2 will come. Then sine 8x by 16 plus 3.